Well, the most fun part of the job for sure is working at the NIH. Gives me the opportunity to try to understand at a very basic level how nature works. Right now, there are experiments going on behind me that will teach us something that no other human being has ever known. We now combine structural biology, biochemistry, molecular genetics, and sometimes even studies in whole animals like mice to study the genes and the biochemical reactions that achieve very high replication fidelity. So one of the goals of the DNA replication fidelity group is to get very high resolution crystal structures of DNA polymerases as they're making new DNA. That can be very expensive and can often fail. And this piece of equipment greatly increases our chances of success and greatly decreases the cost of that effort. So what this robot is capable of doing is setting up a very large number of different conditions in an attempt to get a good enough crystal of a DNA polymerase to get the kind of information we need to understand why defects lead to things like cancer or have other adverse health consequences. This is Marta, who recently joined my lab from Warsaw, Poland, and she is constructing a yeast strain that is disabled in a gene that we think is important for human health. The little colonies growing on these petri dishes are individual colonies of yeast cells, and the one in my left hand contains a very large number of colonies, and that's because those cells are growing on a petri dish containing everything the cell needs to be happy and grow well. Rich media. The petri dish in my right hand contains many fewer colonies, and the reason that's so is because even though we put a very large number of yeast cells on that petri dish, only a few of them can grow because they have a mutation in an important gene that allows them to grow on that kind of medium. So the difference between many colonies and few colonies can be measured, quantified, and used to calculate the actual mutation rate in this yeast strain resulting from inactivating a gene that's important for replication fidelity.